Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Monday, April 19th, 2010. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback on this video. No matter where you're watching this video at, fxbootcamp's YouTube page, our Facebook page, fxbootcamp's Twitter page, whatever, please leave a comment when you're done watching, even if you just say hi or thanks. I would really appreciate that. Now I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account, so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. What you now see is a 3-minute chart for the euro-yen currency pair, as that chart looked at 9:30 a.m. New York time on GFT's DealBook 360 trading platform. Now this pair is just, at this point in time, this pair is just 4 pips higher than it was at the open of the London session, and there are no major economic news releases scheduled for today. So from that perspective alone, hardly any meaningful movement since London Open, you might decide to wait for the market to provide you with some direction before you take a trade on this pair. And as I've discussed often in prior videos and in my London Less sessions, if we're going to see a new direction on the yen crosses, the euro yen as example, this is one time for it to start. 9:30 a.m. New York time. That's the open of trading on the major U.S. stock exchanges, and it is not unusual to see volatility in the currency market increase within minutes of that time. So, how can you profit from that? Well, the Japanese yen tends to get weaker when major stock market indices rise. So if, for example, S&P 500 index futures jump up soon after the equity market open, and if the euro-yen also makes a similar move up, you might look to go long the euro-yen on a pullback, which in this case would be a smaller drop down in price, in the hopes that both S&P futures and the euro-yen will ultimately move higher. So the classic entry in that case, go long on the dip. About 2 hours prior to this point in the trading day, we were discussing in the lab class today's price action on this euro-yen 3-minute chart. Now, what caught my attention was the price action around the 123.70 area. That area, which you could define as a roughly 6-pip range which straddles 123.70, that area was support before London Open. It was resistance after London Open. Now, I told the live class that if this pair were to break above that area sometime later today, then that area could contribute to a trade plan for going long on the euro yen. More specifically, the 123.70 area was support earlier, resistance more recently, and could become a source of support again. During the 6 minutes after the opening bell on the New York Stock Exchange, we see a jump up in S&P futures, and the euro-yen makes a move as well. Okay, great. If you want to go long now you're looking for a pullback, in this case, again, a drop in price. Hey, let's see how that played out on a 1-minute chart with indicators. I've used yellow lines on this 1-minute chart to illustrate the 6-pip zone straddling the 123.70 level that I mentioned earlier. Now, as the euro-yen is testing the top of that zone, as you can see in here, the stochastics indicator on this 1-minute chart is in the oversold zone. Now, if you're looking to go long, that is a no-brainer. Take the shot. Stochastics oversold as the euro-yen is testing likely support in the context of the recent move up. So you're in at or just below 123.75. Your stop loss is initially positioned at least 50 pips below your entry for catastrophic protection purposes. And your exit strategy could be to close a trade for roughly 15 pip loss. Again, 15 pip loss roughly if the euro yen drops below one of these swing lows 4 minutes before the U.S. equity market open. Back now on the 3-minute chart. Several minutes after your entry, you can move your stop loss to the break-even point as the euro-yen touches the 124 level right in there. Okay, fast forwarding now about 2 hours later. And we see that the euro yen peaked near 124.30, then basically drifted during the 90 minutes leading up to the London close, represented here by the red vertical line. Now, you may have exited the trade at the London close right in here for a modest profit of about 25 pips, or you let it run, you let the trade run, in which case you're looking at a nearly 50 pip profit as I speak. I should also add that the euro USD rallied by more than 50 pips up from its daily M1 pivot point, so there were profits to be had from that pair as well. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Monday, April 19th.